Coarctation of aorta is a narrowing in the proximal descending aorta. It can be a discrete narrowing or a tubular one. Usual site is opposite the erstwhile ductus arteriosus, and it is thought to be due to an extension of the process of natural closure of the ductus to the aorta. The usual location is post subclavian, though it can be before the origin of the left subclavian. When a patent ductus arteriosus is associated with coarctation of aorta in a child, the coarctation can be easily missed as the lower limb pulses may not be feeble as in isolated coarctation. This is because the ductal ampulla opposite the ductus reduces the narrowing of the aorta. In a neonate with severe coarctation, symptoms may start with the spontaneous closure of the ductus. The important physical findings of coarctation of aorta are the delayed femoral pulses, brachiofemoral or radiofemoral delay, and the collateral pulsations in the region of the scapula. Systolic or continuous murmur may be heard over the site of the coarctation at the back. Findings of associated bicuspid wall with aortic stenosis or regurgitation may also be noted. Electrocardiogram may show left ventricular hypertrophy due to the hypertension or associated aortic stenosis. X-ray chest shows the characteristic rib notching of the lower borders of 3rd to 8th ribs due to the erosion by the tortuous posterior intercostal arteries. It becomes more prominent as age increases, and the sclerosis at the edge of the notch makes it quite visible. Rib notching is not seen in the upper intercostal spaces, as both the posterior and anterior intercostal arteries arise from the high pressure zone proximal to the coarctation, while in the lower spaces the posterior intercostal arteries arise from the low pressure zone below the coarctation. Unilateral rib notching occurs in pre-subclavian coarctation on the right side only, as both anterior and posterior intercostal arteries will be in the low pressure zone in this case. Collateral pulsations may be felt posteriorly in the region of the scapula. The natural history of unrepaired coarctation of aorta is poor and is characterized by aneurysm formation, dissection of aorta, hypertension, heart failure, and premature coronary artery disease. Even individuals whose coarctation has been repaired are more prone for hypertension and coronary artery disease. Still picture from an aortogram in coarctation of aorta in lateral view. The catheter is seen along the anterior border of the aorta. Pre-stenotic and post-stenotic dilatation of aorta are visible. Post-stenotic dilatation is much more prominent. COAO, coarctation of aorta, DIS-IO, descending aorta. In this case, though the gradient across the defect was low, the post-stenotic dilatation was considerable. This illustrates the fact that there is no direct correlation between the severity of the obstruction and the post-stenotic dilatation. The coarc segment is seen as a shelf-like negative shadow extending anteriorly from the posterior border of the aorta, arrow marked as COA. The region marked as DIS-IO is the post-stenotic dilatation. Left subclavian artery is seen originating just above the coarctation and coursing upwards. So this is a classical post-subclavian juxta-ductal coarctation of aorta. This is a still picture from aortogram of coarctation of aorta in LAO view. LSA, left subclavian artery. Coarc segment is seen as a constriction just below the origin of the left subclavian artery. The prominent post-stenotic dilatation of descending aorta is also visible. Pre-stenotic dilatation is not very prominent. Important methods of repair are by patch aortoplasty, either resection and anastomosis, or subclavian flap angioplasty. Alternatively, a bypass graft can be used to bypass the obstruction. Stent, angioplasty, or surgery for coarctation of aorta. A non-randomized observational study compared stenting, balloon angioplasty, and surgery for coarctation of aorta in children weighing more than 10 kilograms. The study period was between 2002 and 2009, involving 350 patients from 36 institutions. They collected baseline, acute, short-term 3 to 18 months and intermediate follow-up beyond 18 months. Stents were implanted in 217 patients, while 61 had undergone just balloon angioplasty. There were 72 patients who underwent surgical correction. Stent was superior to balloon angioplasty in coarctation of aorta in achieving a lower upper limb to lower limb gradient acutely. Surgery was superior to stent in coarctation of aorta in terms of the gradient at short-term follow-up. As expected, stent patients had shorter hospital stay than the surgical cases. They had also fewer complications than the balloon angioplasty and surgical patients. Aortic wall injury was more likely in balloon angioplasty cases. Authors advised caution while interpreting the results of this report because of the non-randomized nature of the study. Here is the journal reference for this non-randomized study. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.